Capture One Pro 7 now has additional tools to help you work tethered to your computer. Tools relating to tethered capture are placed in the Capture Tool tab. The first tool, Exposure Evaluation, gives an indication of the exposure level for the currently selected image. The scale is approximately from -2 to +2 stops. Set up the naming format of the captures in Next Capture Naming. Clicking here will allow the creation of personalized naming formats. In this case, we are using a name coupled with the camera counter number. In Next Capture Location, decide on where to store the captured files. Depending on whether you are working with a catalog or session, the dialog will look a little different. First, for working with catalogs, choose in Store Files whether to place the captures inside the catalog itself or nominate a folder by selecting it in the pull-down menu. Remember, this is where the raw files will be stored. Under Collection, choose to show the captures only in the Recent Captures Fixed Collection in the Library tool or another chosen collection. To nominate a collection, for example an album, as a capture collection, right-click on it and choose Set as Capture Collection. If you are working with sessions, leave Store Files set to the Capture folder and nominate a different folder by choosing it from the pull-down menu. For both methods, the amount of space left on the chosen storage is indicated here. Next Capture Adjustments handles how adjustments from one capture to the next are decided. Select the ICC profile to use here. Leave default selected for normal operation. All other adjustments are handled in the next pull-down menu. Leave Copy from Last selected to simply copy adjustments from the current image to the next as you capture. Any updates made to the image will then be automatically applied to the next capture. Otherwise, choose a different option for your preferred workflow. To shoot with a style applied, first choose Defaults with Styles and then pick a style. Check Auto Alignment to level images automatically if working with a Phase 1 IQ digital back. First, connect your camera by simply plugging it in. Check to see if the camera is connected in the Camera tool. Choose Settings for your camera here. Options for Camera Control are now active in the Camera Controls tool. Continue by setting the desired options in the menu or on the camera itself. If Manual Mode is selected, it is then possible to select Shutter, Aperture and Exposure Value. Capture One Pro 7 offers additional functionality, including the ability to change the flash mode, where an attached flash gun can be set to front curtain, rear curtain, or to red eye reduction. The option will show if the equipment is compatible. Capture an image by pressing the shutter button on the camera, clicking on the capture button in the camera tool, or use the shortcut Command K. The capture will then display in the viewer. There are some additional options for tethered shooting in the camera pull-down menu on the menu bar. Each new capture taken in composition mode overwrites the previous one. This mode makes it possible to shoot multiple test shots without filling up hard drive space. X-type icons are placed on the screen to warn that this mode is active. If you are working tethered with a third-party camera not supported by Capture One Pro 7, enable the hot folder function. Shooting to this folder with another utility will then make sure Capture One automatically adds new captures to the catalog or session. The Auto Select New Capture option decides when the next capture will display. Never will show the chosen primary variant. Immediately will show a new capture as soon as possible, before all sharpening calculations are done. When ready, will show new captures as soon as all auto adjustments are done. Auto Pause will allow the viewing of a selected primary variant while the tethered session continues. Capture One Pro 7 now has support for live view from a DSLR. Enjoy the same experience of working on your studio monitor as you would on the camera LCD. This can aid composition and accurate focusing. Click on the Start Live View icon in the camera tool. The Live View window will open. To pause the feed, press the icon in the left of the toolbar. The toolbar is divided into three areas. On the left, there are controls for activating or deactivating the overlay function, showing or hiding the alignment guides, choosing between a monochrome or RGB image if supported by your camera, a shortcut to the capture preferences, and finally a shortcut to customize the toolbar. In the center are three cursor tools for panning, zooming, and setting the white balance. On the right-hand side are the standard image zoom tools. To aid focusing, zoom the live view window to 100%. Under live view controls, adjust the focus on the lens by using the icons here. Use the center icons for fine focus and the further icons for progressively coarser focus. The overlay feature can be used to aid composition. This function is often used to shoot an image that will match a specific layout. For example, an image could be captured for a magazine cover where space needs to be left for a masthead and headline copy. To view an overlay image, simply drop an image file into the overlay area here and alter the opacity, scale, and placement as needed. To close live view, simply close the window. Overlays can also be used on a static image in the viewer. The functionality is the same when adding the overlay tool.